We're told that you need to do a better job getting the word out. This message is, there's a lot of voices to this message, and you'll see some of those voices here today, the people behind them.
The capital plan that we have to make improvements to Baldwin County schools. We've been working hard on this, and I want to reiterate what we're all about and what we're working for. I heard just a few days ago that portables were good enough for our students to learn in. Well, as I stand here with the rain falling behind me and Gulf Shores Elementary portables, just a few of the ones they have, I'm here to say it's not good enough. And when I look across Baldwin County, the county I love, the county I grew up in, it's not good enough in Elsinore that they have 1/3 of their school in portable classrooms. It's not good enough at Fairhope High School, Spanish Fort High School, Robertsdale High School, where students are eating outside because the cafeteria is not large enough to hold all of them.
Hi, my name is Kelly Sims. My husband and I have lived in Gulf Shores for the past 13 years. We have two daughters that attend Gulf Shores Elementary. Our oldest daughter is in fifth grade and our youngest is in third grade. One of the main reasons we chose to live in Gulf Shores is the quality education system. The teachers and administrators are some of the best, and we couldn't be happier with the educators who work with our daughters. With that said, our third grade daughter has now had her classroom in a portable for the second year in a row. The first year we were in a portable, I was very concerned. Will my child be safe? Where will she go to the restroom? Will there be enough room for all the students? I still have these same concerns with the second year in a portable. I urge you to join my husband and me and vote yes for all five measures on the ballot next Tuesday, March 31st. Thank you for your time.
In Spanish Fort, they lose 15 minutes of classroom time because their hallways are so congested. In Elsinore, they can't even have tables or chairs in their library. In Loxley, they put up temporary dividers so that one classroom can be turned into two. And in Robertsdale, they can't even have school-wide assemblies.
A lot of y'all know that economic development is kind of one of my favorite parts of the job in creating opportunities where government can create an environment for private businesses to thrive. We're recruiting companies from all over the world. When we sit down in meetings and conference rooms, or we're sitting down at supper to talk about why they should come to Baldwin County, we talk about how great the beaches are for maybe 5 minutes, the fishing, the hunting, the quality of life that we have here with regards to how great our people are. We talk about that for such a little period of time and what the county and the state would be willing to do for infrastructure needs, for roads, for to help them with recruitment here. We only talk about that for a few minutes.
And we're going on. We have a few more days. Let's do everything we can. Let's rally our troops, and let's make this happen for Baldwin County. Thank you.